स्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं नमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। प्रणम्य रामाभिधमात्मधीपदम् जगत्प्रसूतिस्थितिसंयमायनम् तदात्मकान् शङ्करपूर्वकान् गुरुम् मयोपदेशार्थविभाग उच्यते in the passage 51, Shishya Vacha, Yadyapi Aham Vidyamanah Tathapi Inna Paramatma. Yes, I am existent, I am Nitya, I am Vidyamanah Tathapi Inna Paramatma, but I am not Paramatma. Why do you say that? Kartvatva bhoktru lakshana samsaro masvabhava. Just a doubt that my experience is that I'm a karta, bhokta, and therefore samsara is kartrutva bhoktru is the nature of samsara, and that is my nature. Pratyakshadivihi prana pramanihi anubhuya tattva anubhuya manatva. I experience myself that I'm a karta, bhokta, I'm a samsari, and this is how, this is my experience, therefore, I'm all right, vidyamana I am, but I'm not paramatma. So this svabhava of mine is pratyakshadivi pramanahi anubhuyamanatva. I experience this svabhava by the pratyaksha, etc., by perception, na avidyanamitta. So teacher said that this conclusion on your part that you are a karta bhokta, I mean it's a conclusion, notion, not a reality about you, is due to adhyasa superimposition. Shishya says, no, it is my experience. Because adhyasa is not possible. No, adhyasa nimitta, no, vidya nimitta. It's not because of ignorance that I take myself a karta bhokta, it is my nature. Why is it so? Avidyayaha svatma vishyatva anupattehe. There cannot be ignorance about one's own self. Alright, what is ignorance? Avidyanama anyasmin anyadharma rupana. What is ignorance? Superimposing the attributes of one upon the other. यथा प्रसिद्धम रजतम प्रसिद्धायाम शुक्तिकायाम अध्यारोपितम अध्यारोपयति जस्ट एज रजतम सिल्वर दैट इज अ वेल नोन एंटिटी प्रसिद्धायाम शुक्तिकायाम अगेन इट इज सुपर इम्पोज अपॉन शुक्तिका और शेल विच ऑल्सो इज नोन एंटिटी यथा प्रसिद्धम पुरुषम स्थाणु अध्यारोपयति Similarly, Purusha also is a known entity, and Sthanu, the stump of a tree, also is a known entity. So, one known entity is superimposed upon another known entity. Prasiddham va Sthanum Purusha. Or vice versa, that one may think that although there is a person, one may think that it's a tree, stump of tree. In which case, the Sthanu, namely the stump of tree, and Purusha, a person or a thief also are known entities. You know them. Na prasiddham prasiddhe. If you never knew what a Purusha is, you could not superimpose upon Sthanu. If you did not know what Sthanu is, you could not superimpose upon Purusha and vice versa. Both entities should be known. If you never knew what a Purusha is, a person is, you cannot superimpose that upon Sthanu, even if you see that. If you never knew what a Sthanu is, again, you could not have superimposed upon that. Na prasiddham prasiddhe, prasiddham va aprasiddhe adhyarobayati. Nobody ever superimposes. Even an unknown thing upon known, or known thing upon unknown. Meaning that adhisthanam and adhyarobaya. So that which is the locus of superimposition and what is superimposed, adhyasthamana, both of them should be known entity, experience, object of experience. Nasha atmani anatmanam adhyarobayati. It's not possible that one superimposes anatma upon atma. Why? Atmana aprasiddhatvat, because atma is myself, cannot be an object of experience and therefore not something that I know. So how can I superimpose anatma upon unknown atma? The atmanam atmani, you say there is a mutual superimposition of self upon non-self, non-self upon self. Like shukloham, so I am fair, I am dark, manushyoham. So, manushyatvam, shuklatvam adi, dharma adi, body, superimposed upon the self, and I think that I am fair, I am dark. In atmatvam, the body is anatma upon that, I superimpose the nature of atma, and I say that it is a body's atma. How can that happen? So, this was presented as an example to show how kartrutva and bhoktrutva also are adhyaropa or adhyasa. That I take myself, karta bhokta is a result of adhyasa, is not the reality about me, for which the example is given just as it is known that body I am not. And still, the dharma of the body, the attributes of body are superimposed upon atma. And again, the selfness or the dearness of the Atma is superimposed upon body. So this was the example given to prove that kartrutva, bhoktrutva also is adhyasa. And therefore, not the nature of self. Therefore, I am not samsari by nature. That's what Guru said. But now, how is it possible that Atma is superimposed upon Anatma? Or how Anatma is superimposed upon Atma? Because both should be separately known. Adhisthana adhyasthimana prasak prasiddhi mantra adhyanu. What do you mean? That Purusha also is known, Sthanu also is known, therefore one known entity is superimposed upon the other. Alright, that we accept. When you give example of Purusha and Sthanu, do you mean that Purusha is separately known at the exclusion of Sthanu? And sthanu is separated by the exclusion of purusha, meaning that both should be exclusive in the own. Is that the condition? Or both should be known, that's all. So, there is no need that both should be separately or exclusively known. Both should be known is a condition, but not necessarily exclusively known. Why exclusion? One known in the exclusion of others. Na vyavichara. So, if you say that Purusha is known independent of sthanu, and sthanu is known independent of Purusha, and that kind of knowledge is the condition for superimposing one upon the other, that's not a rule. That both them should be known, but not necessarily separate from each other. Nihivatsa prasiddham prasiddha evadhyarobayati tiniyantam shakyam. That one thing, independent known alone, is superimposed upon, and the independent known thing, you cannot make it a rule. Vyavichara, because there is a violation of the rule. Atmani adhyaropana darshana. So you say that one cannot be gauroham krishnoham iti deha dharmasya aham pratyaya vishaye atmani. So gauroham I am fair, krishnoham I am dark is a well-known notion about oneself. And everyone knows that the fairness, darkness are the attributes of the body. And still we take ourselves to be fair and dark. So you know that that is definitely adhyasa. Deha dharmasya. So gauratvam, krishnatvam. Fairness, darkness, dharma are the attributes of the body. Aham pratyaya vishaye atmani. They are superimposed. Atma, which is the aham pratyaya vishaye, meaning something known as aham or I. Aham pratyaya vishaye atmana. And the atma that is known as I is superimposed upon dehe. I am asmi. I am this body. So this is what people take. So already there is so. Now this is the example. Shishya, all right. So in what way the example that you are giving is different from what I am claiming? Shishya says, I am claiming that both of them should be known. And one known entity can only be superimposed on another known entity. Now, sir, you are saying that Atma is known as I, and the body is known as this. So both are known. So what I am saying alone it applies here also. So, prasiddevatari atma aham pratyaya vishaya. So, sir, what you said is that atma is known as I, meaning that as the object of the notion I, or concept I. This same it in body also is known as I am this. So, atma is known as I and body is known as this. So, both are known. So one known entity alone is superimposed on another known entity. That's what I'm saying. So in what way the example given by you is different from what I am saying? Tatra evam sati prasiddeho eva dehatmanoho itaretaradhyaropana. So the example that sir you are giving seems to be similar to sthanu purushayo suktikarajadayo eva. The sthanu and purusha, mutual superimposition. Ashuktika, rajata, again superimposition. Where in each case, both entities are known. Here also the atma and body both are known. Tatra, kam vishesham ashritya bhagavata uktam. So then, your revered sir, when it is said that both of them should be known is not a necessary condition in which you give the example of the body and the atma. So to me, these both are also known. Body is also known as atma is known as I, body is known as this, so both are known. Like sthanu also is known, purusha also is known. sukham visheshama asidya bhagavata uktam. So in what way the knowledge of sthanu and purusha and knowledge of atmana, in what way is it different? That you are saying that the sthanu purusha example does not apply here. So your claim that both of them should alone separately does not apply here. Guru Rahad and Guru Deshrun, Satyam, Prasiddho, Deha, Atma, it is true. Deha and Atma, the body and self, both are known. True. Nidhu Sthanu Purusha, but not like Sthanu and Purusha. Vivikta Pratyaya Vishayata, Saraloka Prasiddho. Everybody knows Sthanu at the exclusion of Purusha, and Purusha at the exclusion of Sthanu. Vivikta Pratyaya Vishayata, as the objects of the different perception, different cognitions. In that manner, Atma and Anatma are not known. Katham Tarhi. So in what way is the knowledge of Atma and Anatma different from the knowledge of the Purusha and Sthanu? Nityameva Nirantara Avivikta Pratyaya Vishayataya Prasiddhau. See, body is not known at the exclusion of Atma. Sthanu is known at the exclusion of Purusha and vice versa. But the body is always known along with the knowledge of Atma. Nirantara avyukta pratyaya vishayatya prasiddhau. Today, Atma also is known along with body. A time will come when Atma can be known without the body. But time will never come when body will be known without Atma. So nirantara always avivikta pratyaya vishayataya, undifferentiated knowledge. So both are known, Atma and body, but body is never known as different from Atma. Whereas sthanu is known different from Purusha and vice versa. To explain, nahi, I am deha, I am Atma iti viktabhyam pratyabhyam dehatmanu grunnati yatah kaschita. Yatah, because kaschita, no one. I am deha, I am atma. This is the body at the exclusion of atma. This is atma at the exclusion of body. Iti viktabhyam pratyabhyam. A pratyaya or cognition of the body which excludes our cognition of Atma, and cognition of Atma which excludes the cognition of body. Nobody ever knows Atma and Anatma in that manner. Therefore, atahayavahi. So that being the case, if the body was known separate from Atma, Atma was known separate from body, there will be no confusion. People know Purusha as Purusha and Sthanu as Sthanu. There are no disputes about what a Purusha is and what a Sthanu is in this world. Everybody is in agreement as to what a person is and what a stump of tree is. But people are not in agreement as to what Atma is. If Atma was known clearly like a Purusha or Sthanu, there will be no dispute about it, because everybody sees it clearly as it is. Because Atma is not known as it is, Atma is always known mixed up with the body. Therefore, or mixed up with the mind, with Anatma. Atah eva, since Atma is not known clearly as it is, mumukhyate lokaha atmanatma vishaya devar. There is a repeated or a moha or delusion about both Atma and Anatma. Evam Atma, na evam Atma iti. Atma is only like this and not like this. So, deha eva Atma, indriyani Atma, karta Atma, akarta Atma, vyapaka, parichana. So many opinions obtain about what Atma is. Somebody says Atma is Anu, somebody says Atma is Vyapaka, somebody says Karta, somebody says Akarta. సగుణ నిర్గుణ ఇది లోకవాది విప్రతిపత్తే. సో పీపుల్ ఆల్సో కన్ఫ్యూజన్, నాట్ ఓన్లీ పీపుల్ బట్ వాది ఈవెన్ ది ఫిలాసఫర్ దేవ్ ప్రాబ్లమ్. సో దెర్ ఆర్ వాదీస్ మీన్ డిస్ప్యూటెన్స్ ఆర్ ద సో కాల్డ్ థింకర్స్. ఆఫ్టర్ ఆల్ ద థింకింగ్ దే కమ్ టు కన్క్లూజన్ ఆత్మ ఇస్ కర్త అండ్ భోక్త లైక్ ది మీమాంసకాస్ ఆర్ లైక్ దోస్ ఫెలోస్ ద చార్వాకాస్ దేహ ఏవ ఆత్మ సమదే చార్వాకాస్ ఇంద్రియణి ఆత్మ మీమాంసకాస్ ఇస్ కర్త ఆత్మ వేదాంతి అకర్త ఆత్మ. So all of the about Atma, there are so many opinions and disputes that shows that Atma is not known clearly as it is. It is known as mixed up with something, always. Sometimes mixed up with body, in which case people think I am fair, dark, etc. Sometimes Atma is known as mixed up with sense organs, so I say I am blind, lame, etc. Sometimes Atma is known as with mixed up with the mind. So people say, sukhi dukhi aham. Sometimes intellect, karta bhokta aham. Sometimes atma, akarta aham. So all of these opinions about atma show that atma is not known clearly. Not known distinctly as atma. It is always known along with something. Not being able to separate. That I see, when I say I am fat or I am lean, the distinction that I am is one entity and fat and lean another entity, that way they are not distinctly known. And therefore, tasmat eka jnana uparaktataya upalambhaiva అధ్యస్యమాన అధిష్టానయో సిద్ధి అధ్యాసే అపేక్షతే. ఫర్ అధ్యాస ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ నెసెసరీ దట్ అధిష్టాన అధ్యారూపా షుడ్ బి నోన్ డిస్టింక్ట్లీ ఫ్రమ్ ఈచ్ అదర్. ఆల్ దట్ ఈస్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఇస్ బోత్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ ఆర్ నోన్ టుగెదర్. బోత్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ బికమ్ ది ఆబ్జెక్ట్ ఆఫ్ సింగల్ ఇన్ వన్ పర్సెప్షన్ బోత్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ ఆర్ ఇన్క్లూడెడ్. మీనింగ్ దట్ వెన్ ఐ సే కర్తాహం భోక్తాహం so or shuklaham krishnaham, the shuklatva and aham both of them are known. So eka jnana uparaktataya, in one cognition both the entities are involved. So krishnaham, then krishna belongs to the sharira, aham belongs to atma. So both of them are the object of one cognition. Uparakta means one is influenced by the other. One is colored by the other. So therefore, the aham is influenced by Shyamaha or Krishna or Shukla. So all that is Nesarva Dhyasa is just both entities should be known, but not necessarily known exclusively. For Adhyasa, what is necessary is two entities should become the object of the same cognition. So when you say the sthanurayam purusha, the stump of tree is purusha, so that means part of the purusha. You say I am sarpa, I am belongs to the rope and sarpa belongs to the sarpa. Sarpa is not known exclusive of rope in this case. A rope is not known exclusive of sarpa. In this, so whether rope is known independently as sarpa elsewhere is a different thing. But in this particular cognition, I am sarpa, that's adhyasa. What is happening? I am, that belongs to the rope. And sarpa, that belongs to the adhyastamana. Both of them are cognized in one cognition. And you are not able to separate that one, aviveka. That I am belongs to the rope. And sarva belongs to the adhyasyamana, that viveka or separation not being known, that is taken to one entity. And so you conclude that this is a snake. So therefore, eka jnana uparaktataya upalambha, upalambha cognition. Eka jnana, one single cognition. What adhyasimana adhisthanayoho? Both adhisthana substratum. Adhyasimana, what is superimposed? Both of them are known in one single cognition as lumped with each other. That is a necessary condition for adhyasa. Not necessarily that they are exclusively known. They are known and they become the object of one single cognition. That is when inability to separate them creates the adhyasa or superimposition. No prusak siddhi, that atma should be known independent of anatma and vice versa, that is not the necessary. Atma and anatma, both of them become the object of one cognition. That's only condition. Ityatah aham karta bhokta iti asyapi. So aham manushya iti. If aham manushya is accepted as adhyasa, because manushya is known to be the attribute of the body, and aham is known as to be atma, and therefore that this is adhyasa, that he accepts, because the body is known as body. So I am deha, that everybody knows, aham atma. So this is krishnoham, shukloham, is an example of adhyasa which is accepted by both the parties. Guru, of course, presented as an example. Shishya also accepts it. Therefore, this aham karta, aham bhakta also is of the same class as krishnoham, shukloham. Ityatah aham karta bhokta ityasyapi aham manushya divat dvyakara pratibhasat. Dvi akara is there. Like what? This aham is one akara and manushya is other akara. Aham is one and karta is other one. And therefore, pratibhasat adhyarupa siddhiti bhava. All right. Then another technical question is asked, yadi nanu atmanatma ubhayavapi yadi adhyasa gocharata. If you said atma is superimposed upon anatma, and anatma is superimposed upon atma, tada adhyastasya mithyatva. Then we know that snake is superimposed upon the rope, and snake is mithya. What is mithya? Mithya is that which has no existence in the adhisthanam. So sarpa, snake, does not exist in the rope at any time. So that which does not have existence in the substratum, and that which still appears to be real, is called mithya, and that is adhyasa condition. So snake is superimposed on rope, and rope is superimposed on snake, because when you say this is a snake, that this is the element that belongs to rope, and so that part is superimposed on snake. When you say this is snake, then this is belongs to rope, upon which snake is superimposed, so that is mutual superimposition. So if according to you, there is mutual superimposition, then both are superimposed. Then what is superimposed has no existence upon the substratum. Like snake is superimposed upon the rope, and snake has no existence in substratum. So according to you, sir, if atma is superimposed upon anatma and vice versa, then atma has no existence in anatma, and anatma has no existence in atma, so both are non-existent. So says Shishya, no, avidya adhyarupitam yatra tat asat tatra dushtam. So what is superimposed upon the other thing, substratum, that superimposed thing is known to be non-existent in substratum. Yada rajatam shuktikayam. Just a rajata or the silver is superimposed upon shell, and we know that silver is no existence whatever in the shell. Stanam puro rajvam sarva, etc., etc. Tatha dehātmanoho api nityameva nirantara avyakta pratyena itaretara adhyarupana krutasyat. Since then, if as you claim If dehatmano api, dehanatma also, nityameva always, nirantara, all the time, avivikta pratyena itaretara adhyarupana kruta syat. Because, sir, you say that the anatma or deha is never perceived or never known without the knowledge of atma. That means they are always mixed up. And that is how the adhyasa is then. Tat itaretarayo nityameva asatyam asatvam syat. If both are always superimposed upon each other, then both will be proven to be non-existent. Yatha shuktikadishu avidya adhyarubhitana rajadadina nityameva atyantasatvam. Just as upon shuktika shell, silver is superimposed, we know that silver is evident, non-existent in the shell. Tadviparitanam cha, and somebody superimposed the shell upon silver, let us say, then the shell is non-existent in silver. In short, what is superimposed is non-existent in the adhisthanam, the substratum. Tadvat dehatmanoho avidya eva itareta adhyarupana kruta syat. Similarly also, if deha and atma, both of them are superimposed upon each other because of ignorance, tatrevam sati dehatmano asattvam prasajyeta. If that is the case, then both deha and atma will be non-existent. Deha is superimposed upon anatma, upon atma, then deha is non-existent atma. And atma is superimposed upon deha, atma is non-existent in deha. So each one becomes non-existent. Let it be. Tachya anishtam. No, that is not acceptable to you. Why? Vainashika pakshatvat says Shishya, sir, you do not belong to Vainashika, so you would not like this position. Vainashikas both are non-existent. Deha is non, atma is non-existent. Deha also is everything, nothing is existent anyway. But by this position of mutual superimposition, it amounts to accepting. It amounts to accepting that the body is non-existent upon atma and atma is non-existent upon body. So both are non-existent, as the Vainashikas say. Atha, tad viparyayana deha atmana vidya adhyarobitaha. So similarly, if deha is superimposed upon atma, then deha syatmani sati asattvam prasajyeta. Then atma is sat, but then deha will be asat, non-existent in atma. If atma is superimposed upon deha, then atma is non-existent in deha. And similarly, if deha is superimposed upon atma, then deha is non-existent in atma. Tachyanishtam, that also is not right. So if you accept Atma is non-existent, then that is Vainashika Paksham. If you say Deha is non-existent because superimposed Atma, then it opposes, you know, Pratyaksha. We see Deha to be there. How can you say Deha is non-existent? So Pratyaksha Adi Virodha. Tasmat. Therefore, what you say, that both are mutual superimposed, tasmat, dehatmanu na vidyaya itare itarasmin adhyarobhita. So, it is proven or established that this deha and atma cannot be mutually superimposed upon each other. Meaning that, this notion that aham karta aham bhokta is not the result of, or even aham, you know, shukloham krishnoham, that I am fair, I am dark, also is not the result of mutual superimposition, in which case both will be non-existent. Kathantari, meaning adhyasa. So, then Krishna, I am fair, I am dark, that is not the result of adhyasa. Had it been the result of adhyasa, it would amount to saying that both of them are non-existent, which is wrong. Atma is existent because you are not Vainashika. there is existence because you see that. So then how do you explain that? Dehoham, manushyoham, katamri, vamshastam bhavat nitya sanyoktao. This sanyoga. Sanyoga means what? That this mutual, the sanyoga is explained. What is it? Conjunction, alright. Sanyoga is conjunction, joining. So both of them are joined. Sanyoga. Two things which are separate are in contact with each other, joined with each other. Vamsha stambhavata. Like, the stambha is pillar, vamsha is a, you can say it is a beam, etc. So all of these are joined with each other. And that's how you have an entity called home. So gruham is one word. So when you use one word gruham, it creates the impression that it is one entity. It's not one entity. It is in fact a complex entity, assembly or conjecture or conjunction of two entities, vamsha and stambha. So you say, I am deha, looks like one entity. But I am is different. Deha is different. Both are not superimposed, both are joined with each other. So there is sambandha, not adhyasa. This is the position of Mimamsaka. Then Guru says, na anityatva parathatva prasangat. See, this is all total theoretical discussion. So theoretically, adhyasa is not possible if, as I understand adhyasa, of course. If the disciple understands adhyasa, the whole idea is to give a clarity about what kind of adhyasa you are talking about. But he understands adhyasa as sthano purushaha, shuktikayam rajatam. That's the adhyasa example. So this is adhyasa that he understands. And if that same model is applied to the adhyasa of deha upon atma and vice versa, then this difficulty comes. So idea is to show that these are two different kinds of adhyasa. That's the whole idea. So adhyasa of deha upon, the sthana upon purusha is one kind, and of atma upon deha is a different kind of adhyasa. That is what the guru wants to show. So the standard example of adhyasa is taken. If that is applied like shiktika rajata, then this is a difficulty, technical difficulty, that both will prove to be non-existent. So rather than accepting that they are non-existent, let's accept another model, not adhyasa model, but the sanyoga model, which is what the Mimamsaka are presenting. All that, if you accept the Atma and Anatma as sanyukta, meaning as conjoined with each other, then anitya parasattva prasangat. So what is joined with another thing is always anitya. Vamsha also is anitya and stambha also is anitya. And parasattva, vamsha meaning the beam serves the purpose of someone else, and the pillar also serves the purpose of someone else. They are there not for themselves, for something else, someone else. And this beam is brought from some place. It did not exist before it was made, and will not exist after it dies. So it's anitya also. Samatattvat parasattvam anityattvam cha vamshastambhadivadeva. Therefore, atma samatattvat, if atma also is assembled, is also an assembly, an aggregate with anatma. Parātattvam, atma then will not be an independent entity. Like a stambha or a vamsha, atma also will serve the purpose of some other conscious entity. The thing is, both vamsha and stambha are unconscious, and they serve the purpose of devadatta, who is a conscious entity. So atma also will have to serve the purpose of some other conscious entity. And atma will be anitya, impermanent. Kincha. All right. Suppose you say that atma serves the purpose of someone else. Then what? Yastu parahi dehena samudha kalpita atma. Like Mimamsaka has imagined that atma, is conjoined with the body. They do not realize what they are landing into. So sometimes you have a position and you realize that that is a ridiculous thing. You know, you make a move in the chess and then you are, that is what do you call it? Checkmate, that's it. So you think that you are doing something and you are checkmate. Similarly also, you try to explain this as samhati, as sanghata, but then this is what will happen. Then what happens is, that by the admitting that Atma is anitya and pararsa, pararsa means serving pararsa, that means you are accepting someone else, you know. If Atma is pararsa, then there is a para. So, yastu parahi dehena samhata kalpita atma. Parai means mimamsakahi. So, mimamsakas imagine that atma is an aggregate, is a part of an assembly. So, they are admitting that it serves the purpose of someone else, you know. That means they are admitting someone other than atma, whose purpose is atma. So, that is atma. Therefore, sa samhata tena asamhata paraha, anya, nitya, siddha, tavata. Therefore, by their own admission, they are accepting an atma, the asamhata. So, where there is sanghata, asamhata must be there. This is the rule. Wherever there is an assembly or aggregate, like a pillar and beam, etc., there must be someone other than them who is not part of the assembly, who must be a conscious being, whose purpose the assembly serves. So, if Atma and body, both of them are assembled like that, and joined, conjoined like that, and both of them serve the purpose of someone else, who is Atma? Who is Nitya? Who is conscious? So, by calling it, in fact, a Sanyoga, you are already admitting an Atma is different from them, and who is Nitya. So, this is how far we were. So, now, we complete this passage 56. Now the Tikagara continues with the passage 57. So let us read that. Nanu satyam sanghatad achetanat anya atman tasya cha sanghata asambandhe aham manushyah इति व्यवहार अनुपपत्ते तत्संबंधो वाच्य ऑलराइट सत्यम सर यू आर राइट संघातात अचेतनात अन्य आत्मा संघात एन असेंबली एन एग्रीगेट इज ऑलवेज अचेतनम इज ऑलवेज इन लाइक अ हाउस इट इज एन असेंबली ऑफ insentient entities like pillars and beams, so house and assembly also is insentient. Sanghatat achetanat anya atma. So if atma and body both are sanyoga, then there is an atma which other than that, who is chetana. Alright, if this is so, then tasya cha sanghat asambandhe. Now you say that Atma is independent of Sanghata. Sanghata is Achetana. Atma is Chetana, unconnected. Like Devata is unconnected with the house. So you say Atma is unconnected in Anatma. So without the Asambandhe, Aham Manushya, Iti Vyavahar Anupatte, then Aham Manushya. Aham is Atma, Manushya is Anatma, both of them occur in one place. So then how do you explain that experience? I'm Manushya. Aham is unconnected with Manushya according to you. Manushya belongs to body. And Atma is unconnected with that. Then how do you have the experience? Aham Manushya. Then tat sambandho. There's some way to explain. So if this sanyoga is not acceptable to you, then what is the relationship? Then again you come back to adhyasa only. If samvedana is not possible, then adhyasa alone is there. Then says, tatra sanyoga visheshasya anangikare tadatma adhyasa sambandha iti ayatam. Then we come back to the whole thing. If sanyoga is not possible, because atma then becomes achetana, anitya. And therefore, for atma being nitya and chetana is independent of sangata, not connected to sangata, fine. Then, but aham manushya, I am a human being, so that I and human me are connected. So how do you explain that connection? They're related, it's connected. If sanyoga is not the sambandha according to you, then you come back to adhyasa, that is superimposition. Yes. Then says, tatha, so, tadatma adhyasa sambandhi ayatam. So it amounts to saying that they are related by tadatma adhyasika sambandha. Not a real sambandha, because both of them do not exist in the same locus. So adhyasa, like the sambandha of the space with the pot. That's what happens. Iti ayatam, it amounts to saying this. All right, yes, we say there is adhyasa. Then Shishya says, so what is tadatma adhyasa? Remember that visheshanam. That it amounts to saying that there is the mutual superimposition. Tadatma means, so tad atma. Atma becomes atma, vanatma, anatma. So like a red hot iron ball. Where iron becomes the atma of fire, and fire becomes the atma of iron. Therefore, there is a mutual identification, not the supreme identification. So they look as one entity. Similarly also, there is mutual identification between the two. So if you accept that, then tathacha niratmavada apattihi iti praguptam shishyah smarayati. If you come back, if this sambandha is not accepted, sanyoga sambandha is not accepted, if adhyasa, adhyasika sambandha is accepted, then this is difficult with adhyasa. That in case of adhyasa, the adhyastamana, what is superimposed, is non-existent in the adhisthanam. So both body and atma will be non-existent in each other, then this is the problem in this same situation that I said earlier. Shishya praguktam shishya smarayati, we already said, the consequence of accepting adhyasa amounts to accepting the non-existence of both. So then shishya says, now the text, tasya asamhatasya dehe dehamatrataya adhyaropitatvena asatva anityatvadi dosha prasango bhavate tatra niratmako deha iti vainashika paksha prapti dosasya. Tasya asamhatasya, that atma is asamhata, is not a part of the assembly, independent of it, unconnected. So you don't accept connection. Sambandha you are not accepting. That means that you say the atma is unconnected with anatma. Then, dehe, dehe matrataya adhyaropitatvena, then both are superimposed. Deha is superimposed on atma, and atma is superimposed on anatma. Except that shishya accept both the kind of superimposition is the same. What the teacher will explain is that the superimposition of deha upon atma is one kind and superimposition of atma upon deha is a different kind. That is why the consequence that you are imagining will not arise. This whole idea of the discussion here. Very nice, this subtle discussion for us to understand the nature of adhyasa. This adhyasa, atma and atma adhyasa. Where the Shuktika Rajata does not apply in totality. Asamhatasya dehe dehe matrataya adhyarupitatvena. And so then atma is taken to be deha, dehe matrataya, and deha is taken to be atma, vice versa. Asatva అనిత్యత్వాది దోష ప్రసంగో భవతి. ఆత్మ ఇస్ టేకన్ టు బి దేహ, దెన్ ఆత్మ బికమ్స్ వాట్? నాన్ ఎగ్జిస్టెంట్ ఇన్ దేహ. అసత్వ మీన్స్ నాన్ ఎగ్జిస్టెన్స్, అనిత్యత్వ మీన్స్ ఇంపర్మనెంట్, ఎట్సెట్రా. దోస్ నాన్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్ వెరీ ఇంపర్మనెంట్ ఎనీవే. సో ప్రసంగో భవ ఆల్ దీస్. సో వాట్ వి సేడ్ ఎర్లియర్, ఇఫ్ యూ ఎక్సెప్ట్ ఆధ్యాత్మిక సంబంధ, దెన్ దే విల్ బి అసత్, దెల్ బి అసత్వ ఆర్ అనిత్యత్వ. సో యూ వాంట్ టు, యు ఆర్ ఎక్సెప్టింగ్ ఆధ్యాత్మిక సంబంధ టు అవాయిడ్ అనిత్యత్వం ఆత్మ. బట్ ఎస్ వి సేడ్ ఇన్ అధ్యాస, ది అధ్యస్తమాన ఈజ్ నాన్ ఎగ్జిస్టెంట్ ఇన్ అధిష్టానం, దే విల్ ద సేమ్ ప్రాబ్లమ్ విల్ అరైజ్. తత్ నిరాత్మకో దేహ, దేహ విల్ బి నాన్ ఎగ్జిస్టెంట్ ఇన్ ఆత్మ. దేహ ఇస్ సూపర్ ఇంపోజ్డ్ అపాన్ ఆత్మ, అండ్ ఆత్మ ఇస్ నాన్ ఎగ్జిస్టెంట్ దేహ ఇస్ ఆత్మ ఇస్ సూపర్ ఇంపోజ్డ్ దేహ. ఇది వైనాశిక పక్ష ప్రాప్తి దోష సత్. అగైన్ యూ కమింగ్ బ్యాక్ టు వైనాశిక. సో లుక్ ఎట్ ద టీకా. టీకా ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్స్ దిస్. తస్య అసంహతస్య, సో దిస్ పార్ట్ ఇస్ ఫ్రమ్ ద టెక్స్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద విచ్ ఇస్ అసంహత, విచ్ ఇస్ అన్అసెంబ్డ్, నాట్ అ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ అసెంబ్లీ. వాట్ డస్ ఇట్ మీన్? ఆత్మ ఇస్ నాట్ సంహత, నాట్ అ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ సంఘాత, దెన్ వాట్ ఇట్ ఈస్? సేస్ సంఘాత సాక్షిణ. సో దట్ ఈస్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్స్ అసంహతస్య. ఈ ఆత్మ ఇస్ నాట్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది అసెంబ్లీ, నాట్ కనెక్టెడ్ విత్ ది బాడీ ఎట్సెట్రా, దెన్ ఇస్ ఎ సాక్షి. అన్కనెక్టెడ్ న్యూట్రల్ విట్నెస్. సో సంఘాత సాక్షిణ. ఆత్మ ఇస్ నాట్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ సంఘాత, నాట్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ అసెంబ్లీ, దేర్ఫర్ హీ సాక్షి, హీస్ ఎ విట్నెస్. విట్నెస్ ఇస్ డిఫరెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ వాట్ ఇస్ విట్నెస్డ్. సో యూ సే ఆత్మ ఇస్ డిఫరెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ సంఘాత, దెన్ ఆత్మ బికమ్ సాక్షి ఆర్ విట్నెస్ ఆఫ్ ది సంఘాత. దెన్ దేహే, దట్ దేహే ఈ కమింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ ది అగైన్ టెక్స్ట్. దేహే మాత్రత. సో దేహే అధ్యారోపితత్వేన, దేహే స్వస్మిన్ అధ్యస్థేతి యోజ్యం. వెన్ దేహ ఇస్ సూపర్ ఇంపోజ్డ్ అపాన్ ది ఆత్మ, ఆత్మ ఇస్ సాక్షి, అండ్ దేహ ఇస్ సూపర్ ఇంపోజ్డ్ అపాన్ ఇట్స్ ఓన్ సెల్ఫ్. బికాస్ వై డూ యూ సే దేహ మస్ట్ బి సూపర్ ఇంపోజ్డ్? సేస్ దేహస్య స్వాతంత్రేణ సిద్ధే అనంగీకారాత్ ఇత్యర్థః. సార్ యూ సేడ్ దట్ దేహ ఇస్ నెవర్ కాగ్నైజ్డ్ ఆన్ ఇట్స్ ఓన్. ఇన్ ది కాగ్నిషన్ ఆఫ్ దేహ, ది కాగ్నిషన్ ఆఫ్ ఆత్మ ఇస్ ఆల్వేస్ ఇన్వాల్వ్డ్. దట్స్ వాట్ సేడ్ ఎర్లియర్. సో నిత్యమేవ ఇతరే. సో నిత్యమేవ నిరంతర అవ్యక్త ప్రత్యయ విషయతయా ప్రసిద్ధౌ. దేహ ఇస్ నాట్ నోన్ ఇండిపెండెంట్లీ. దేహ ఇస్ ఆల్వేస్ నోన్ విత్ ది కాగ్నిషన్ ఆఫ్ ఆత్మ. మీనింగ్ దట్ యూ సేడ్ దేహ ఇస్ నాట్ నోన్ ఇండిపెండెంట్లీ. సో దేహస్య స్వాతంత్రేణ సిద్ధి అనంగీకారాత్. యూ డు నాట్ ఎక్సెప్ట్ దట్ దేహ ఇస్ నోన్ ఇండిపెండెంట్లీ. They are always known with along with the Atman, but then we are not able to, they are not separate, Deha is never separately known, Deha is always known in conjunction with Atman, meaning that nobody ever knows Deha independently. Dehasya svatantrena siddhi anangikarat. You say that Deha is not known independently according to you, and Deha is always known along with Atma, therefore Deha is always superimposed upon Atma. Because the condition was that both of them, so eka jnana uparaktataya upavalambha. So dehai and atma both are known as object of one cognition, and therefore dehai is superimposed on atma because the condition of adhyasa, that both the entities are known in one cognition, a applies to Deha and Atma, because Deha is never known independent of Atma. So Deha is always superimposed upon Atma. You will accept that. Then, tathāca tādruṣe dehe adhyārūpitattvena hetuna ātmanah dehamātrataya asattva anityatvādi dosha prasangu bhavati. Tathāca tādruṣe dehe, this deha of which the independent cognition is not accepted, or independent existence also is not accepted. Upon that deha, which is what? Which is in itself unreal, because it is superimposed. Upon that deha, adhyarupitatvana hetvana. Now if there is mutual superimposition, then Atma is superimposed upon deha, which itself is non-existent on its own. What is deha? That which cannot be cognized independently. You follow? What is called existing? That which can be cognized independently. Like gold is cognized independently, or clay cognized, but pot is never cognized independently. Pot is always cognized along with the cognition of clay. And therefore, pot is not existent on its own, understand? Pot does not enjoy independent existence. So it is not satyam. So deha also does not enjoy independent existence, because deha is never known independent of Atma, just as a pot is never known independent of clay. So naturally, pot is superimposed upon clay, deha is superimposed upon Atma. And now we say that mutually, therefore Atma is superimposed upon Deha also, because there is a Tadatma Adhyasa. So Tathaja Tadrushe Dehe, a Deha that does not enjoy independent Satta, upon a Deha like that, Adhyarupitatvana Hetuna, Atma is superimposed upon a Deha like that, which itself is not proven independently. Deha Matrataya, then Atma is taken to be Deha, Deha is taken to be Atma. Deha Matrataya Asattva Anityatvadi Dosha Prasanga Bhavati. Deha is Asattva, because Deha does not enjoy independent existence, so it is Asat. And Anitya also. So if Atma is superimposed upon Deha, and Atma is known as Deha, then Deha is Anitya, Asattva and Anitya. Atma also become Asattva and Anitya. So that is what this is the explanation of this text. Tasya asammatasya dehe dehe matrataya adhyarupitatvena. So dehe, the tika said, swasmin adhyasta iti yojyam. Deha, when it is superimposed upon Atma, and then Atmani dehe matrataya adhyarupitatvena. Atma is superimposed upon Deha as Deha. So Deha Matrataya Adhyarupitatvena, so that's Hetu. Tathaja Tadrushe Dehe Adhyarupitatvena Hetuna. Atmana, so Asattva Anityatvaya Dosha Prasanga Bhavati. The text said, Atmana, so Asattva Deha Matrataya Asattva Anityatvaya Dosha Prasanga. Atma become Asattva and Anitya. If Atma is superimposed, Deha is Asattva Anitya. Deha is Asattva because not known independently. It is Anitya that everybody knows. And thereby Atma is superimposed upon Deha. Atma also becomes what? Asattva and Anitya. Then the text is Tatra Niratmako Deha Eti Vainashika Paksha Prapti Syat. Then Deha will be non-existent of Atma. But that's the other way around. So says Tatra Evam paraspara adhyasa abhivagate sati iti yavata. Tatra means what? So even though text does not clearly say that, the Tikaka interprets the text as meaning that there is mutual superimposition. Text only seems to say that Atma is superimposed upon Deha. But here, Dehe, so Deha is also superimposed on Atma, and Atma is superimposed upon Deha. So Tatra means what? Paraspar Adhyasa Abhivagame Sati. You accept the mutual superimposition. So Tatra is Sati Saptami. That being the case, what being the case? That both of them are mutually superimposed upon each other. Then what happens? Deha, niratmako deha, naturally, if deha is superimposed on atma, then there is no existence in atma. So then text in Dika says, adhyastasya mithyatva niyama niratmako deha nirdehakascha atma iti shunyavada prasanga ityartha adhyastasya mithyatva niyamat. What is superimposed is mithya. What is mithya? Mithya is that which is non-existent in the adhishthana. That's called mithya. That's called mithya which does not exist in the substratum. Just as the snake, rope snake is mithya because the rope snake does not exist in rope at any period of time. Trikalepi. Kalatrepi natishtishtati or natishtati in mithya. So adhyastasya mithyatvaniyam. Adhyasta is non-existent in adhisthanam. Therefore, deha is superimposed on atma. Therefore, deha is non-existent in atma. So niratmako deha. And again, atma is superimposed upon deha. Therefore, nirdehakascha atma. Atma doesn't have deha and deha doesn't have atma. Atma is superimposed on deha, so there is no atma. The deha doesn't have atma. Deha is superimposed on atma, there is no deha, so atma is without deha. So atma is without deha and deha is without atma. It is shunyavada prasanga. Without atma means it doesn't exist. And therefore, both of them will be non-existent. So that is shunyavada prasanga. So if you do not accept this sambandha like Mimamsakas, where the Atma and Atma is conjoined with each other, to create this concept, Aham Karta, Aham Bhokta, in which case that becomes real. Because Stambha also is real, Vamsha also is real, and the house also is real, connected, you know, the assembly. So Atma is real, and then Anatma also is real, and the concept Aham Karta also is real. So Aham Karta, that fellow performs karma here, and Aham Bhokta, that fellow experiences the result in heaven. That's what they want to show. If that is not acceptable to you, the only position that left is mutual superimposition. Then we come back to what we said earlier, that what is superimposed is non-existent in that substratum. So if deha is superimposed upon atma, deha is non-existent of atma. Atma is there without deha. And atma is superimposed upon deha. But deha is there, atma is not there. So niratma kaha deha, nirdeha kascha atma. That's what Vainashika said. So if you accept the tadatma adhyasa, then this is the situation. So then the teacher has explained what kind of adhyasa this is. Okay.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavad Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah. Om Shanti Shanti. Shanti Shanti Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.